Good morning and welcome to the Roundtable Panel, The Week in Review. I'm Sarah LaDuke, the producer of the Roundtable on WAMC. This past Thursday, May 25th, WAMC announced the retirement of founding president and CEO Alan Chartock. Here is Ray Graff from that morning's regional newscast shortly after 9 a.m.
This is WAMC News. I'm Ray Graff. We begin with some breaking news this morning. After more than four decades leading WAMC Northeast Public Radio, Dr. Alan Chartock is retiring as president and CEO. The 81-year-old called his 40 years at the station the journey of a lifetime, adding that it's time for a new group of leaders to take the helm. Then a political science professor at SUNY New Paltz, Chartock started leading WAMC in 1981 when Albany Medical Center handed over the FM signal. Since then, WAMC has grown into an award-winning 29-station network serving seven Northeast states.
We've all done this together. This is not one person, that's for sure. It's been a great ride. I just love WAMC. But it really is time to retire. I'm going to be, I hate to say it, 82 years old. It's time for a break. I never thought I would, but here we are. It's time to let others take over. And all I got to say is I really love you all.
The executive committee of WAMC's Board of Trustees has named Stacy Rosenberry, Director of Operations and Engineering, as the organization's interim CEO. While Chartock's retirement is effective immediately, the board says he stands ready to continue to help in any way. A full celebration in honor of Chartock is being planned for a later date. It has been an honor, sir.
WAMC's Ray Graff. After Ray's newscast, a modified roundtable panel of sorts assembled to congratulate Alan on his decades of service and to share stories with listeners. This morning's roundtable panel, The Week in Review, will feature excerpts from that broadcast. Take it away, Thursday, Joe Donahue.
Well, here we are. Good morning. It is the 25th of May, 9:14 on this Thursday morning. I welcome you to the roundtable and to a very special program this morning. And I thank you for being here. One of the things about WAMC that is consistent is its wonderful audience, the wonderful listeners, and we thank you so much for being here with us and also being here with us during special and poignant times in our history and in our lives. And if you were listening to Ray Graff's newscast a moment ago, and who wasn't, you heard the news that our beloved CEO, Dr. Alan Chartock, has announced that he is retiring. And after more than 40 years of service to this radio station, and when I say service, I mean creating the damn place, he has decided to retire. And as you heard in the clip from a moment ago, we talked to him yesterday, and he said, you know, I didn't think I would do this, but now I had a couple days off, and I think I'll do this. So it is today that we are going to celebrate Alan. Here's the best retirement gift to all of you that I'm going to give to Alan, which is we're not going to talk about Twitter and Ron DeSantis.
Good.
Yeah. So instead, we're gonna spend our time, and we're going to talk about Alan, and we're going to talk about the incredible legacy that he leaves and continues. And we it's a bittersweet day for all of us. And we really never thought it would come. I assumed that when I was, you know, in my dotage in my 70s, I would leave and Alan would be at the front door and say, oh, you know, can I have the keys back? And But, you know, over the last couple of days, a lot of people have reached out and wondered what was going on and wondered where Alan was. And and Alan wanted some time to think and to figure this out. And he did and figured out that what he wanted to do was to spend time with his wife, Roselle, with his children, with his grandchildren, with his friends. And yes, more walks. So we're going to celebrate Alan today. I was, over the last 24, 36 hours, I've been thinking about what we wanted to, you know, who we wanted to have in the studio. and to have be on the our panel, if you will. And three immediate names came to mind, and I'll introduce them, and then we'll talk a little bit to them individually about their thoughts about what this is. But first, Mike Spain, who is a WAMC board member. He is a panelist. He's known Alan forever. He is a former Times Union associate editor. He's a dear friend, and all momentous occasions of this radio station, I have... he has been here, and this did not seem right to not have him with us today. So, Mike, thank you very much for being here.
Thank you very much, and it's a little bit poignant, as you said, to be sitting in the studio. And Alan's always here every Tuesday, so Alan, I miss you already.
Yeah, I really do, and I also want to, then on Monday, Libby Post is our regular panelist, and she is a political consultant, but more important, she was Alan's student. Alan always joked that I taught Libby everything she knows, and Libby would respond.
No, he would say, I made you what you are today.
Yes.
And I would respond, yes, Alan, because of you, I'm a lesbian. And he would laugh. And had a good sense of humor about it. And there
He's
you go.
Laughing right now.
That's
right.
Good. A very good point. So, Libby, we love you. And thank you so much for being a part of the gang.
Well, as we were saying before, I really feel honored to be here to be a part of this. I mean, I have known Alan since 1982. When I started graduate school, I took three classes with him. People go to me, really? And I was like, yeah, three classes over three semesters. So you can only imagine. But, you know, he taught me how to teach, which is lecture and then bring in speakers. And so that's what I do, is I lecture and then I bring in speakers. But he brought in some of the most, you know, well-connected, well-educated people in government that I've ever run into, and so it was always a good class, and he was a good teacher, and he still is.
Well, and a teacher to you in a traditional mm-hmm. setting of education, and a tremendous teacher to me. I've had this job for just under 30 years, and in the fall it'll be 30 years, and I you know, you can't calculate what he taught me/us, and there are a couple of us who have been here for a really long time, for decades, but David Gustina has been here a little bit longer than I have, but the grand prize winner is Selma Kaplan.
I thought you were going to say grandmother, and I was going to get a little bit ticked about that.
No, but. Georgia, I'm not going there. Selma, as it's been 40 years?
35-ish.
35-ish. Selma tried to retire a couple times.
It's true. I did try to retire, and I'm still here.
Yes.
So there you go.
Still here. And, you know, since we stopped doing the fund drives during COVID, the quote-unquote traditional way, the way that we've always done fund drives, Selma and I haven't had our time together. So we're going to one of the things. So here's the little secret, is that on Monday of this week, this past Monday, we were supposed to open the lockbox. We were supposed to start the lockbox. And because Alan was away and it was deciding, and we decided to put it off and to wait until we knew what we were dealing with, and this will probably surprise no one, but Alan said, "Well, I'm retiring. Now you go make the money." Right, so
pretty much, he said that even before he retired.
Yes, and so here we are, and we're going to do that this morning. I think we have said in the press release that went out today from the company, from the board, that we have a summer drive, and there's no better way to honor Alan and honor Alan in his retirement than to help us and to put some money in the lockbox into the fund drive. Those two may end up merging with one another, but that's okay. It's WAMC.org, and we'll get into that in a few minutes, the full-scale fund drive part of it. But I just want you to know that is something that Alan very much wanted. I think we feel that it's just the most appropriate thing that we possibly could do to honor a man who's given his life to this radio station. And now we'll be going into this new chapter of retirement, and to say that we did this maybe even in a day. He always wanted
mm-hmm.
that, you know,
that would
do
be
it
great.
In a day.
That would be great.
That we could do that. So if you're sort of reeling from the news like we all were, then that's a great thing that you can do. And it's WAMC.org, and just hit the donate button. I want to just mention two things before we start here with our wonderful panel and our wonderful group. But first of all, kudos to our amazing board, and our board of trustees led by Dottie Reynolds and also with Ann Erickson and Joe Brody, who were really have worked very much with the staff and with Alan over the last several days and making this all official, and the work that they've put in and the thoughtfulness and love that they've put in has just been staggering and beautiful. Mike Spain has been a part of that as well, which is why it's so special to have him here. The other story, and I hope this emerges, today is all about Alan, and it will be all about Alan, and it should be all about Alan, and it will be all about Alan. But I just want to mention that through all of this, because Alan has stepped away and is no longer our CEO, that the board has named Stacy Rosenberry, who had served as our Director of Operations and Engineering, as the interim Chief Executive Officer. And I think everyone in this room and everyone in this building, quite frankly, would agree that there is no better choice in the world than Stacy to take this. We all know that no one can replace Alan. We all know that that's not possible. But we also know that Stacy is an incredible manager. She has an amazing temperament, has an amazing thoughtfulness, and even-keeled. And I am, I remember saying this to Mike Spain a couple days ago, when things were a little less sure, and I said, "Well, I'm glad my livelihood isn't at stake." And then when we heard about Stacy, I just said, "Well, okay, this is, you know, it's going to be different, but it's going to be okay."
Well, it's probably the best testimony to Alan of all, the fact that he has people so prepared and so good at their jobs that they could literally just step into that seat and, you know, do what needs to be done, because he surrounded himself with really amazing people.
The group is incredible, I at some point we'll go through, probably we'll mention almost all of them. Amber Sickles is here, who is of course our membership director and is at the top of that list. David Gastina, who is, I think, is after you, Selma, has been here the longest. Of course, Ray Graff and Ian Pickus, our news director, and the list goes on and on. And we'll get to that list in a little while. So we want to talk about Alan. We want to share stories. We welcome you to share stories. You know, it's weird because it's a celebration. It's a celebration of Alan. It's a celebration of his career. It's a celebration. Retirement is a happy thing. But it's weird. You wouldn't know, Selma, but it's weird because, you know, it's like Alan isn't, you know, isn't going to be here every day. And that's just very weird for those of us who've been here a long time and just always expect him to be at our side. But we'll put that aside and work on the fetting part. And the celebration part to make sure everyone knows just how special this man has been, not only to this radio station, not only to the group of colleagues that I am with today, but also to this community and to public broadcasting overall. How did you meet Alan Selma?
How did I meet Alan? I was looking for a part-time job. I was playing music at the time and wanted something to put, food on the table. And I got a job here putting cards in alphabetical order as the sort of assistant to the receptionist. And back in those days, every person who contributed to the station had a little index card devoted to them. This was long before computers. I am so ancient. Grandmother is right. And I put things in alphabetical order and worked here part-time, and that's how I met Alan. And Alan tells this story, which I actually don't remember, but he was looking for somebody to write a grant or develop a paper of some kind, and I said, I can do that if you like. And I did it, and he was pleased, and he offered me a job, and I never left. That's pretty much it.
And you have had many, many, like all of us, I think this is safe, we all have this story, right? We've had many, many jobs.
Well, like
many,
Libby
many
said,
titles.
You know, he made me the person I am today, not a lesbian, but
too bad.
I didn't get the toaster oven, sorry.
Yeah, I know.
But I think I've sat in every chair in this building, and at the moment I'm sitting in Alan's chair, which is very daunting. I mean, this is the chair that Alan always sits in.
Right.
And my feet don't reach the floor. But then again, nobody's feet reach the floor in this room because it's built for really tall people like Joe. Anyway, I've had every job in this place, sat at every desk, you know, in every building, and kind of left the day-to-day operations and have been serving as a part-time senior advisor kind of person for the last few years. And I'm really, I never imagined that Alan would retire before I did.
Right. And I think, a lot of us feel that way. And it is remarkable how much he has achieved, remarkable how much, we talk about Alan's longevity here, but he created this radio station, and not only created this radio station, but created a community and created a family. And when you listen to that list at the top of every hour, I mean, every one of those was Alan saying, this is how we can make the station better.
Yeah, well, it started with a 4-second ID, WAMC, Albany, New York. Boom.
And now it's all over the state.
Yeah.
Mike?
Yeah, I remember Alan's story about those early days when WAMC was handed over to Alan and a group of community people.
Yeah.
And they didn't have a dollar to keep it going, so they began the first fund drive. And Alan tells the story about the then mayor of Albany, Erastus Corning II, came into the studio and put down $100 and say, there you go. And that was kind of the kickoff, you know, or one of the big first kickoff donations. And it was an act of faith. And the nice thing about that is, Alan, you've always kept the studio right here in Albany. You've been true to the home of where WAMC was founded. And by all intents and purposes, the station that you're listening to now was founded and envisioned by Alan back in the early 1980s. And what a vision. I mean, who could have ever imagined? I mean, you said all over New York State, Libby, but it's actually a big audience in seven different states.
Yeah.
And then now there's people all across the globe, really, who I heard somebody last week, Joe was on reading some comments on the Roundtable, and he said so-and-so from Paris or something like
right.
that.
That's John.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
And you can listen anywhere. And you can connect from anywhere now. And it is a remarkable institution. And, you know, it's a courageous thing when the founder of an organization, especially one as successful and far-reaching as WAMC, makes a decision, a very tough decision, I'm sure, to step aside and hand over the reins. But what makes it work is Alan set up a team, and the team that he set here is impressive. And now led by Stacy during this period of change that's going on. And it's it is really a testament and an act of unselfishness to step aside and sort of let the ship go now. And you know, everybody, it's doing very well, and it will do very well because of you, Alan. Thanks.
Right. Now what do we do?
Well, there are three words I never thought I'd hear. Alan Chartock retires.
Yep.
Right. No, that's absolutely true. And but as I said, you know, here we are, and I'm thrilled that Alan came to this decision because as Mike alluded or Mike said that, you know, it's obviously a tough decision, and so the fact that he has is happy with it, and has left us now to go on and to keep his legacy alive is a great honor.
WAMC's Joe Donahue. On this week's Roundtable Panel, The Week in Review, we're sharing excerpts of our celebration of Alan Chartock's career as he announced his retirement on Thursday. We'll be back with more after this break. Welcome back to a special edition of the Roundtable Panel, The Week in Review. WAMC's founding president and CEO Alan Chartock and the WAMC board announced Alan's retirement on Thursday morning. We also opened the lockbox in honor of Alan. Pledging online at WAMC.org is available 24/7, but please don't call with your pledges right now. The 7 a.m. on a Saturday staff is not ready for you. Once again, you can pledge online anytime at WAMC.org. Back to you, Joe Donahue, from Thursday morning.
We broke a story, as we always, as we're wont to do, being a great news organization. But we broke Alan Chartock, our wonderful. that sounds wrong. We broke the story about our great Alan Chartock. We didn't break Alan Chartock.
He's still picks.
No, he's fine. We broke the story. He announced his retirement, and we made that announcement just about a half hour ago, and it's you know, it's hitting the papers, and it's people are responding. If you'd like to write to us your remembrances and thoughts of Alan, we'd love to hear them. panel@wamc.org. This morning, over the next 2 hours and 20 minutes or so, we are going to try to raise as much money as possible to put that money in the lockbox. We're a couple days behind. We were going to start the lockbox on Monday, but we waited, and because we wanted to know, you know, what Alan's decision was. He made his decision, so now we'll do it. We can think of no better way to honor Alan than to open the lockbox and to have you help us out as we move the radio station forward and take this incredible jewel that he created and allow it to flourish in the future. I want to just mention that our Ann Erickson and who is a board member and former board chair, and went over and spoke with Alan yesterday. And I just want to play a little bit of that talk because he's talking about fundraising and talking about retirement, and I think it's appropriate to do so. If we could go to cut 02515, this is Alan Chartock talking about the fund drive.
So we are about to launch into a fund drive.
We are.
Yes. And is there anything you'd like to say to the listeners and members and supporters and those who do challenges?
Well, you know, and when I said team, I meant team. But the biggest part of the team are the listeners. The biggest part of the team are those people who turn the radio on every day and then let me know about it and let you know about it and tell us all that they couldn't do without it. They couldn't live without it. It's so important to them. I can't think of another public radio station in the country that has anything like it. This is really a coming together of a whole bunch of people who really want to make it work.
Mm-hmm. And that's really what does make it all work. It's the coming together. And we've been saying, you know, as you step down at this point, it is, you're leaving behind the...
I'm stepping down? Oh, no.
You know, you're leaving us in such a good place in terms of the strength of the organization, the management, the on-air personalities. But really, you've built the community that's going to make sure this continues.
I don't think there's any question that the people who turn the radio on every day expect it to be there and will make it be there and will do everything in their power to assure all of us that it carries on. Because in the end, it ain't me and it ain't you. And you know what it is a bunch of people who have decided together that they're going to make a radio station. Whereas the old story went, let's make a real radio station, and we've all done it together. Mm-hmm. And that's what's so great about it.
Yeah, and I don't know if you remember that very first drive, that SOS, Save Our Station.
Right.
And people really did step up and save it and then help it grow.
You know, Ann, I'm glad you mentioned that because I'll never forget it. Mm-hmm. It literally brings a tear. It literally brings a tear to my eye when I remember that we went on the air and we said, we've not done this before, but we can do it, but it's on everybody. And everybody took up the cudgels. Everybody decided this was their radio station. They were going to make it their radio station.
Alan Chartock talking to Ann Erickson, who is a wonderful WAMC board member who spoke with Alan yesterday, and about this decision and about his decision to retire, which is what we're talking about this morning. Also about the importance of fundraising. We have a lot of letters, and I'm going to get to some of them in a few minutes. And one of the things when we're doing the panel regularly, you get... This is why people get mad that we don't read every letter, and of course we can't, but a lot of them are repetitive. Mm-hmm. You know, they're basically saying the same thing. But I'm amused in some of the, just looking a very quick sweep of the letters, but I've seen five already that have this theme in them. Oh, I used to see Alan regularly when I went to visit the allergist. My back doctor, or
my physical therapist.
That's right, exactly. Right. Alan was known not only for the radio, but for a lot of doctors' waiting rooms, apparently. And that is very funny. We'll get to some of those letters in a few minutes. We welcome you. We welcome you to help us this morning. And it's really, it just seems to me, Selma, that it's, I haven't hesitated for a second because it just seems like totally the appropriate thing to do to be talking about Alan's retirement and also talking about
money.
A fundraise.
Yeah, yeah. It's mm-hmm. just, what would Alan do? He would raise money. What I'm remembering right now actually is the fact that Alan predated fax machines.
Yes.
And predated computers. And there used to be a UPI machine in the newsroom,
yes,
clacking away.
Wow.
And thing, I mean, what he has seen just in his tenure at WAMC, and he's, you know, when the cell phone came out, when the, you know, we used to have these weird old computers, and, you know, he still needs a little technical help occasionally with his computer. But there you go.
Don't we all?
Don't we all?
Yeah,
right.
Don't we all?
Don't we all? But just the technological advances and the fact that he was able to sort of keep ahead of them and keep the station ahead of them. And we went from, like we said before, one radio station to, you know, 28 radio stations and a huge online presence. That was all the visionary work of Alan.
It really is. And we know how important it is. Libby, I mean, you do this, certainly working with a lot of nonprofits and helping them keep going and mm-hmm. helping them grow. And that fundraising is always a difficult thing. And for us, it's been, you know, relatively difficult. But Alan created this whole new way
yes.
of going to the listener and making it very successful.
You know, when I do a fundraising workshop, I talk about if you're in baseball, if you have a 300 average, you're a slugger. In fundraising, if 3 out of 10 people say yes to you, you're a champ.
Yeah.
Right? And it's the individual's prerogative whether or not they want to give, and it's not about you and you, the asker. You know, it's not about you. It's about what people want to do. But Alan has been able to build a fundraising apparatus and machine here that routinely gives because people have an emotional attachment to this station. They think it is important. It gives them hope. It gives them the information that they want. And in this day and age, what we're dealing with outside of these 17 walls that we're in, right, because there's all these offices.
Yeah.
But it is even more.
It used to
more...
be a car dealership. Just don't forget.
Oh, that's
that.
Right. This is true. But yeah. It's even more important, you know, that WAMC does what it does to get the news out there and to get people the information they need. And I think people value that. They value the people who give, and there are lots of people who give, value what the station does for them each and every day.
You know, to your point, Libby, of making the money, I was telling the story the other day and reminiscing about I used to be news director and before the show even, I think, and and that's 20 plus years, so God. But anyway,
who's counting?
I went to the Public Radio News Directors Association, which I think is Prindy, so I don't know what the I means. But anyway, they had a seminar on the 3-minute pitch break. And I thought, well, I should go and learn about fundraising. I'm, you know, still new to this, and I'll go. And so they went around the room. There were about 20 of us, people that are on the air who raise money for public radio stations across the country. And they said, well, how long is your average break? And I said, well, we start at 6 and we end at midnight. And they said, no. How long is like each individual break? And I said, we start at 6 and we end at midnight.
And the breaks are the news.
And they said, well, how long are your breaks? And I said, well, we go on at 9 and we talk till about 12. And they said, well, no, you're not talking the entire time. I said, oh yeah, we're talking the entire time. And they and then they basically, and I'm not even making this up, but they basically kicked me out. Like, you don't make sense. You know, we don't know what you're talking about.
That's so interesting.
Go off into the world. But it always amazed me because it was this way of making money and fundraising that Alan created, which was. He was the founder, is the founder of the station, is telling people how the station came to be, is bringing in the community and making sure that people are a part of that community. And one of the things that struck me, even before I started working here, and this became the station that I so wanted to work at, was the, it doesn't matter if you give $5 or $50 or $100 and you're a part of this radio station.
Look what we've got. We've got, you know, an incredibly loyal listening audience, 500,000 listeners a month, a staff that, you know, loves to come to work in the morning, and, you know, just the best fundraising around.
WAMC's Selma Kaplan. On this week's Roundtable Panel, The Week in Review, we're sharing excerpts from our celebration of Alan Chartock's career as he announced his retirement on Thursday. A full press release is posted on our website at WAMC.org. Welcome back to a special edition of the Roundtable Panel, The Week in Review. I'm Sarah LeDuc. I could say we were surprised by the outpouring from WAMC listeners and members that we received on Thursday as we announced Alan Chartock's retirement, but we weren't surprised. We're used to sharing experiences with the at-home and in-car part of the WAMC family. In the final segment of today's show, we'll hear a number of listener emails, but by no means do these represent all that were sent.
I want to get to some of the letters,
and
we'll do that. Susan writes to us and says, I beg to differ, but Alan Chartock did not dedicate himself to the radio station. He dedicated himself to creating a public forum, one that would provide a balanced, mostly, with a winky, and diverse news and entertainment source that drew on local, national, and global issues and people from every perspective to allow the listeners to make their own informed decisions and choices. And we all applaud him for it. The best legacy would be to continue doing exactly the same thing, WAMC. And that's exactly what we're going to do. And we thank you, Susan, for that note. We go to Claire while driving periodically between family in Albany and my home and on Long Island. In the days before Sirius and the internet, I would scan the FM dial trying to find any clear station to pass the traveling time. When I got to the Hudson Valley, I found this talk radio with a man with the most reasonable, peaceful voice, and he was always interesting. With minimal adjustments to the dial, I could hear him all the way to Albany. Now, as I listen every day through the magic of tech, no matter where I am, I just want to say thanks. I wear my WAMC socks today in your honor. All the best. And from my experience, retirement is great. Nice letter from Claire this morning. If you have missed the news, Alan has announced his retirement. He has retired from WAMC. He took some time off to decide what he wanted to do. And he came out and said, you know what? I want to take some, I'm going to retire. I'm going to give the station to a new group that I've picked. They seem ready. We'll show him.
You are ready.
They seem ready. And maybe I can spend time in Great Barrington and take walks and maybe, just maybe, and he never said this to me, but I'm just, you know, privately praying He doesn't have to get up at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah. You know, I wonder what's next for Alan. You know, I know that, you know, walking the streets of Great Barrington is a big part of it. Maybe gardening. Maybe Alan, you'll be plucking your banjo a little more. I don't know. But when I was at a retirement party for another person one time, I heard some great advice from one of the speakers. They said, "Now, when you retire, if you have dry cleaning to pick up and you have groceries to purchase, don't do them on the same day, because then what would you do tomorrow?"
Somehow I don't think that that's going to be Alan's.
No.
He'll probably start a new business or, you know, invent something.
My father, in his retirement, used to do things like he would make a to-do list, and he said, "Oh my God, I'm so busy today." And Kelly and I are looking at each other like, "What the hell is he doing?" And then we'd look at his to-do list, and it was like, take soup out of cupboard. Put soup in pan.
Oh, come on.
Heat soup. No, I'm serious. Go to the post office, buy stamps. Yeah, it was a very long list, you know, and if you do it like that, it's a lot to do.
It fills your day.
That's right, yeah, absolutely.
No, but I'm sure it'll be a wonderful, rich retirement with family and, you know, and pursuing all those things that you never have time for. And you're right, maybe he'll start a new business and who knows what'll happen. But innovation.
As long as it's not a public radio station.
Yeah, don't do that. No.
Hey, he's got that gorgeous
been
pool.
There,
maybe
done
he'll
that.
Take up, you know, triathlon or
that could happen.
Biking.
Esther Williams style kind of thing. Is that what you're saying? 81 years old and soon to be 82. And I had just decided that it was time. And I just want to Ann Erickson was just stuck her head in a few minutes ago, and we were talking to Ann. She went over and spoke with Alan yesterday, and we played a clip early on, and it was just a beautiful clip. But I also want to I would just like to of course, Roselle is key to this story, and Roselle is Alan's wife, and
the lovely
bride. Roselle. Bride of 51 years, 52 years, is it?
I remember there was a roast of Alan many years ago, and we did it where you know the most appropriate place to do a roast is at a car wash.
Armory.
And, yeah, we did.
Oh, you did it when there was.
Yeah.
Okay. Fine.
Yeah. So we did a roast of Alan at a car wash, and I had never played a car wash before, but it was great.
It's like
was
right
really...
up there with Four Seasons Total Landscaping.
Very, very true.
No Rudy Giuliani at that tribute party.
Very, very true. But, you know, we all went up and we said our things, and it was very funny. But Roselle just, you know, just slayed everybody.
Does everybody remember her line?
Because her well, the line we can say on the radio. The line was,
"It's not easy being married to Alan Chartock."
And she kept on coming back to that as a recurring theme throughout and it was very, very funny. Ann talked to Roselle yesterday, and I'd just like you to hear what they had to say.
If I may, I was wondering if we could bring Roselle in on this.
Absolutely.
Because you have been here every step of the way through this incredible journey, and I know we haven't always gotten to see you, but we always hear about the lovely Roselle and day, night, fun drives. What are you going to miss, or maybe more importantly, what are you going to not miss?
Well, I have the same sentiments as Alan does in terms of the community. That love is so obvious and clear to all of us. And I am in the head of the line for loving for a lot of reasons, besides him, you know, Alan bringing this incredible station to life. I've been very fortunate to, I think we're going on our 53rd wedding anniversary. And that doesn't mean he's not hard to live with, because he can be, any creative person has all of these energies. And all I can say is I've been in awe of him all of my time with him, total awe. How do you do it? The same as many of the listeners say, how does he do it? Does he ever stop? Does he ever sleep? Well, you know, rarely. And he has an energy that is extraordinary. It's as simple as that. And I've watched it, and I still don't understand. I used to say, actually, when people said, how does he do it? I said, I'm telling you from my heart, he's from another planet. That's how he does it. There is no one else like Alan. And I've just been the lucky person to spend my life with him and continue to do so.
Sweet words from an amazing woman, Rizal Chartock, and who has been so... We've been talking to her through all of this, and it's just been an amazing run of their 53 years, and I know she very much is happy that he will not be up at those weird hours and out and about, and that she'll have an eye on him, and that is all good. We're raising money in Alan's honor this morning. Of his retirement, we have a special roundtable. We're calling it a panel, but it's just a group of friends who have come together to remember somebody that we love very, very much. I am joined by Libby Post, Mike Spain, and Selma Kaplan. And we welcome you. We welcome your letters. We welcome your money. We welcome your donations. If you would like to share with us some thoughts or reminiscences of Alan, we would love to hear those. panel@wamc.org, or better yet, with a pledge, and you can do that online at wamc.org. just hit the donate button, and we'll go to town. I want to get to some of those letters. As I said, there are many, so we'll try to roll through some. Chris said, I started listening to WAMC in 1995 as a renter near Rhinebeck, and I was hooked. The station was a frequent companion in those years, as was Dr. Chartock, and came with me online when life took me to Los Angeles. 2,800 miles away, I still felt a part of the community. Now back in the Hudson Valley, I feel that even more intensely. Thank you, Dr. Chartock. That from Chris.
Yeah, that's notable, too, because the station, which was an Albany station back in the early 80s, has an enormous listenership throughout the Hudson Valley, elsewhere, too. Don't get me wrong. But I mean, it just seems so much of the whole Hudson Valley, right up from the suburbs of New York to north of us, is just a central core of the listenership.
Let's see. I want to read this note from Jocelyn, who said, we love you, Alan. My partner and I think of you often when we utter whatever to each other. We'll miss hearing your Alanisms every day. And I know you will miss them, and we'll miss them too, although I do have to say that we've all, and we're not always happy about this, but we've all inherited those Alanisms.
Many of them.
So you find yourself...
When you're a family long enough, you find yourself repeating things that...
Whatever.
Whatever. I'm sitting here thinking...
And all the rest of it.
We should have an Alan trivia game, like, okay, for the win, Libby Post, where did Alan go to junior high school?
Erasmus.
Joan of Arc.
Joan of Arc junior high school. Yes.
Oh, junior high school.
Yeah.
Okay.
I walked past Joan of Arc junior high school not that long ago, and I sort of stood a moment of silence, a moment of reverence. I took a picture, sent
not
it to Roselle and Alan,
but to Alan.
Yeah. We got a note from Sarah Chartock, Alan's daughter.
Oh, how great!
Which is very sweet, and said, "I'm so incredibly proud of you, Pa, for all that you've done for the station and for all of those whom you brought into this community. That includes the very courageous decision to pass leadership on to the next generation. Even more importantly, I'm proud of you for who you are. Mazel tov, Papa. Can't wait to celebrate together." And that's a beautiful note from Alan's daughter, Sarah. We go to another note this morning, and again, we welcome yours. Tom says, I can't clear the lump in my throat. Memories of Alan appearing on TV 13 back in the Ed and Chris Capostasi days, not shaving his beard until the state budget was passed. Certainly one of the great faces for radio ever. A little smiley emoji.
Alan could take it.
May God bless Alan. May God bless you all forever. thanks. And thank you, Tom. That is very sweet. You know, that is one thing that, you know, Alan, when Alan retired, Alan has retired other things. He retired from the state university system.
Yep.
He retired from Channel 13 and most
before
recently
that, Channel 6.
Channel right. 6. And then also his column. And now.
And the Legislative Gazette.
That's right. The Legislative Gazette. That's
you know,
absolutely
we can't forget
right.
That.
No, we can't. I did, but we can't.
Yeah.
And yeah, so it's and now WAMC, and it just is a testament to the amazing things that he has done and accomplished. And
I'm just having this great memory. There used to be a store around the corner called Finnegan's.
Yeah, yeah. Everybody's
still there.
Oh, it's still there.
Everybody
around
well,
the corner.
This
yeah.
is back when Finnegan was Finnegan's.
Oh, yes.
And Alan went in to get his dreaded Diet Pepsi. I was with him, and some guy walked in and said, "I know you. I know you. You're Al Sharpton."
Oh God!
It was so great. And Alan just said, "Thank you."
Yes.
Thank you for watching.
That is great.
Hey, what was the name of the summer camp that was up in the Hudson Valley?
Camp Rock's House Emmanuel.
Okay.
Camp what?
Camp? Bronx House Emmanuel.
Bronx House Emanuel.
Yep.
Okay.
Bronx House Emanuel.
Second grade
that.
Music teacher. There was Mr. Steiger, I'm sure.
Yes.
He taught something. Mrs. I don't remember.
Mrs. Wicks.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, the nasty lady who chose her favorite to be the person to honor Eleanor Roosevelt.
Oh, that's right. the Satellites music from
Out of This World.
That's yeah. right. John says, my very best wishes to Alan Chartock, who today announced his retirement after over 40 years as the CEO of WAMC, the NPR station he founded. The finest such station in the nation, a gem.
Yes.
Unique. The least cookie cutter of the bunch. This is quite an accomplishment because the National NPR Station Network is also a national jewel. Wishing you all the best, Alan, and wishing you all the best to the staff and leadership that will follow. I can't wait. Well, there's not a nicer sentiment than that, is there? Lois writes, my very first reaction to this morning's announcement was, oh no, I thought this day wouldn't come. And then my second was, I'm so glad the celebration is happening now and Alan is here and is enjoying it and listening to it. WAMC has been my radio station since the days of Susan and Selma offering pigs in a bottle. I think that's what it was. It's been a long time. No, it was pigs in a bottle.
It was pigs in a bottle. I still have a pig in a bottle.
I have a pig in a bottle, too.
It was a cow in a bottle.
That's right. It was a cow in the
it
bottle.
It was a cow in the bottle.
It was pigs flying.
Pigs fly.
Yeah.
Cow
pigs fly.
In the
cows in the bottle. And
yeah.
and
what radio station would give away a cow in a bottle? I mean, I just to me that was the essence of WAMC.
Herkimer.
Diamonds.
Well, you guys were talking about how the audience is so loyal and they step forward every time there's been a fun drive, and they really have and continue to. But, I mean, I think it's because, like Alan said yesterday to Ann, this radio station is unlike any other public mm-hmm. radio station across the country. I mean, whenever I travel, I tune in the local stations around the country, and they're great. Don't get me wrong. They have great content. A lot of that is NPR-fed stuff, and certainly you get that at WAMC. But the local content here gives everybody a voice. You know, it has so many unique – I mean, it's got something for everybody, don't you think? And I think that's why you have built such a loyal audience, Alan, and congrats on that.
Well, I think, you know, you say there's no other radio station like WAMC in the panoply of public radio. There's nobody like Alan. I mean, you know, I mean, really.
He's from another planet, I heard.
Well, I won't comment on that. But, you know, there really isn't. I mean, he has the talent and the drive. I mean, he put together an academic life and then rolled it into practical, which is not something that usually happens.
That's so true.
And the practical is this. And, you know, I remember, you know, when he didn't shave because of the budget and all that sort of stuff. But the other story is, and I don't know, I think this might be part of that budget story. was Fred Dicker, Alan, Norman Adler. That story where, you know, somebody got kicked.
Yes.
The reporter got kicked, and how what news that made. And so Alan also makes news as well as reports news.
Well, we're right. Overlooking you're, years and years yeah. of Mario Cuomo.
Right.
I know.
Right,
that
right.
that was the golden era.
Yeah. Alone.
That's
are
right.
enough to make a book.
Yeah. In fact, there was that. One. Right.
And yes.
I know that book inside and out.
I mean, but it's really, you know, yeah. not everybody has, in Yiddish, it's sechel, right? Not everybody has that ability.
Oh, Joe learned a new Yiddish word.
I know.
Yeah. Right.
To translate for us Gentiles.
Words Mike and I can say.
Well, you can. You probably couldn't say it because it's guttural.
It's got the chuh. It's got the chuh.
Yeah, it's got the chuh. You know, I just think it's good to recognize the talent.
It's so true.
We are honoring Alan Chartock today. Alan is retiring. He has said, okay, enough. And after 81 years being on this planet and 40 plus of those years being here at WAMC, he has decided that it is time to enjoy the other wonderful things
the next 80
about
years.
Life. All right. Betsy said, I will so miss Alan Chartock, especially during the tumultuous upcoming election season 2024. His insights and intellect, not to mention humor, will be missed. I'm so glad he started this station, and I am forever grateful. I've been listening to WAMC for about 40 years, says Jim, and will miss Alan. I sure hope he will now go to bed later and get up at a reasonable hour. Or get cows and learn how to milk them.
Or put them in bottles.
Yes, or put them right. in bottles.
The cow.
Cows, pigs, whatever. Let's see. We go to this note. Holy heck! I came out of the bathroom and heard you talking, Joe, and thought, what happened to Alan? He is retiring. And she said... That she wishes him well. So thank you very much. Let's see. When I moved, Telesport says, when I moved back to this area after being away for some 20 years, I was pleased to unearth my photo of Alan and Mario in the studio autographed by Alan to me. When I wrote and told Alan of my find and what I was rejoining, he kindly sent me the bobblehead of him with Murray at his side. They continue to watch over me from the top of my desk. All the best. To a fine, fine man. That from Telesport. Let's see. Gloria says, I'm a 78-year-old ex-Marine sitting in my pickup truck with a few tears right now. Sad that my morning mentor is retiring, but tears of joy for a man who has lived an honorable life. Thank you, Alan. Truly a mensch. You know, we got a letter from Jonas, and we got it at the same time with Sarah. But because my email box has been blowing up here, it sort of lost in the queue. So I apologize for that. But Jonas says, "Happy retirement, Alan. I have called into the fund drive year after year to say so. So I'd be remiss if I didn't wish my hero, my pops, a very happy, much deserved retirement. I'm so incredibly proud of you. Love, Jonas." So a beautiful honor to his dad from Jonas, and great kids, really very, very
great kids,
sweet.
Great grandkids, too.
Great grandkids,
terrific grandkids. Great grandkids are different.
WAMC board member and former associate editor of the Times Union, Mike Spain. WAMC's founding president and CEO, Alan Chartock, announced his retirement on Thursday, May 25th. Full episodes of the Roundtable Panel are available online at WAMC.org or via podcast. The Roundtable has Monday off to observe Memorial Day, but will be back with a full show on Tuesday. I'm Sarah LaDuke. This hasn't really been the Roundtable Panel, the Week in Review, but thank you for listening.